Treatments against coronavirus. Eat garlic, like raw garlic.
Drink hot water every 15 minutes. Does wine work?
No ice cream? No.
Hi, have you also heard about all those remedies and don't know who to trust? What if we talk about what science says? My name is Odile from Naos Communication, a team of scientists and communication specialists working to bring science to your homes. In this first video, we'll focus on how research has mobilized to deal with the COVID-19 pandemic and the treatments currently being considered to fight the virus quickly, safely, and efficiently. As of today, more than 2 million people around the world have caught COVID-19. And 15% of them have to receive special care, pushing hospitals well over capacities. Since no vaccine is available yet, a treatment to contain the crisis is desperately needed. Usually, for a treatment to go from the lab to the market, it must undergo clinical trials, a standard approval procedure that can take up to 12 years and cost around $1 billion. The procedure goes like this. Researchers first use animal subjects to study the efficacy and toxicity of the treatment. Then they assess the safe dosage and side effects in a small group of healthy volunteers. And only after this step is the treatment tested on patients, first on a few hundred to study how well it works, and then on thousands of patients from multiple locations. After this phase, the drug finally goes to market, though it continues to be monitored for a few years. But can we wait all this time? And what about them? Oops, sorry, wrong app. Since we are in a rush to fight this pandemic, researchers and public health agencies like WHO have taken a different strategy. Scientists have identified several drugs already used for other diseases, so approved and proven safe, that could be repurposed to fight COVID-19, offering possible quick new treatments.
So that we're clear, there is no proven effective therapeutic or drug against COVID-19. However, there are a number of drugs that have shown promise.
But if some drugs have already shown promise, why is it taking so long to make them available?
Dosages of those drugs, when they're given to what patient, at what stage of the disease, has not been standardized. And we've never had a comparison group where we've had a randomized approach to treatment with the drug or not treatment with the drug.
Exactly. In other words, the efficiency, dosage, and safety of these drugs against COVID-19 have not been clearly assessed yet. To start using these drugs in a controlled fashion, many clinical trials have been launched worldwide. The biggest is Solidarity, designed by WHO. Solidarity is the first speedy clinical trial to test treatments on thousands of patients simultaneously worldwide. Although there is still somebody who does not think so, the Solidarity trial stands out in a few ways. First, it ensures widespread testing and results, because any patient can be enrolled. It also guarantees scientific accuracy, with patients randomly allocated to one of the treatments. The results are shared among institutions worldwide, and any new promising drug can enter the trial and be quickly assessed globally. The most promising drugs included in Solidarity are remdesivir, chloroquine, or the less toxic form hydroxychloroquine, a combination of ritonavir and lopinavir, and these two together with interferon beta. Remdesivir was developed to fight Ebola. Some think it could be used in early stages of COVID-19 to stop viral spreading. It has shown good results in the US and is considered the most hopeful treatment. Chloroquine is primarily used to prevent malaria. COVID-19 appears to be sensitive to high doses of these two treatments, but high doses can create many side effects. In a recent small trial performed in France, hydroxychloroquine showed little effects in patients, but the study was not conducted properly. So at the moment, there is not enough evidence to use these drugs in patients with COVID-19. Lopinavir and ritonavir were first used to treat HIV patients. They have shown potential against other coronaviruses, but it's unclear whether they will work for COVID-19. A recent small clinical trial in China showed little effect, but the patients were all in critical conditions. This study suggests this combination might be more helpful in the early stage of the disease. This mix has proven successful for MERS, another coronavirus. At the beginning of the infection, interferon beta acts as a potent activator of the immune system, while the two other drugs fight the virus directly. For this reason, this mix might also be recommended in early stages of COVID-19. There are other drugs, like tocilizumab and infliximab, that modulate the immune system. They are not yet included in Solidarity, but they have recently shown very promising results in independent clinical trials in Italy, France, and China. These two treatments are closely followed by the scientific community because they might be a good choice for patients in critical care.
The challenge is that many of these clinical trials are small in size, which makes it very difficult to draw any conclusions, which is why it is very important that we have these larger trials, these multi-site trials, the Solidarity trial that WHO is running, to be able to have enough cases to be able to get an answer to which drugs work safely.
Having all these different options is great. However, in the context of COVID-19, none of them has proven to be safe yet. This is why massive clinical trials like Solidarity are very, very important. More and more hospitals around the world are participating to this trial. A good treatment option will drastically reduce both the number of patients in intensive care and the amount of time they spend there, not to mention to protect our heroic healthcare workers. The faster patients are enrolled in Solidarity, the faster we will have a true treatment. In our next video, we will tell you more about why this virus is so dangerous and how all the treatments work to protect and heal the human body. Help us to spread this message and give us a like or share. And remember to go Nows!